Hi, Professor. It's good to have you here.
Thank you.
Talking about the equals 13. The first question is related to that. How important is to you the equals 13 being held in Vila Real? It's the first time in Portugal. How important is that?
Oh, it's a wonderful opportunity for me. I've never been to Portugal before. And one thing I really enjoy about ICULS is that every year or every time it takes place, it goes to a different country. And so we get to taste some of the flavor of academic scholarship of that particular place. And so I'm really looking forward to understanding more about Portuguese higher education and Portuguese academic life.
Okay. The next question, what is your opinion about the quality of the communications and the Congress itself?
Well, it's only just started, but it seems to work perfectly so far. The buildings are all very beautiful. Everyone has been extremely helpful. And Gonçalo Fernandes has organized the conference beautifully, I think.
Okay.
So I'm really pleased to be here, and I congratulate the organizers on their accomplishment.
History of linguistics is often mistaken, confused with historical linguistics.
That's true.
What do you think is the reason for this happening?
Well, historical linguistics is a much larger field, and people who are interested in the history of linguistics, so how people have studied languages, how they've understood languages over time, is quite a small group. But of course, we're also interested in the history of historical linguistics, which adds to the confusion of names there.
Okay. Portuguese is not yet considered a scientific language, and therefore magazines worldwide renowned about this field and do not accept Portuguese articles. Why you think this situation will be changed in a few years? Or not?
Well, it already is changed, because I noticed that Professor Kerner's work has been recently translated into Portuguese, and so readers of Portuguese will be able to read his words. And also that raises the stature of Portuguese as a language of scholarship in this particular field. So I'm looking forward to a change there, and I certainly think that more the use of different languages to study a unique subject like the study of the language sciences is an advantage to everyone. So studying it in French or studying it in German is slightly different and advantageous to all parties.
With apparent disinterest and clear disinvestment, political one, in the area of humanities, do you think this will be changed in the future? The more interesting, the students are having more interesting of that or not?
Well, at my own university in the US, I think there's a strong commitment to humanistic study. My university really fosters that. And as one of the speakers said this morning, I think it was the rector of the university, that the humanism is really basic to human experience and human life. And so it's, although I understand that the sciences now have more fashion, more high fashion, and attract more attention, still it's really impossible to imagine a civilization that isn't interested in humanistic values. So I have high hopes.
Thank you.